Right, we got three Fords that are in.
Yeah.
The run-ins. Have to see if we can get them all in the final. At least half of them.
Yeah.
Chris. Hi, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I would like to call the October 18th, 2021 Crest Hill City Council meeting to order. If everyone will please rise for the pledge allegiance to the flag.
No.
I pledge allegiance
to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Roll call, please.
Ray Solomon.
Here.
Glenn Conklin. Scott Dyke.
Here.
John Verche.
Here.
Darrell Jefferson.
Here.
Claudia Gazal.
Here.
Tina Oberlin.
Present.
Mark Sepidi.
Here.
Nate Albert.
Here.
Joe Kubal.
Here.
Thank you.
Okay, you have before you the minutes of the city council meeting held on October 4th, 2021. Motion would be in order.
So moved, Mayor.
Second.
We have motion by Alderman Albert, seconded by Alderman Jefferson for approval of the minutes of the October 4th, 2021 city council meeting. Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Scott Dyke.
Yes.
John Verche.
Yes.
Darrell Jefferson.
Yes.
Claudia Gazal.
Yes.
Tina Oberlin.
Yes.
Mark Sepidi.
Yes.
Nate Albert.
Yes.
Joe Kubal.
Yes.
Motion carries. Thank you.
Okay, you also have before you the minutes of the work session held on October 11th, 2021. Motion would be in order.
So moved.
Second.
We have motion by Alderman Sepidi, seconded by Alderwoman Gazal for the approval of the minutes of the work session held on October 11th, 2021. Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
John Verche.
Yes.
Darrell Jefferson.
Yes.
Claudia Gazal.
Yes.
Tina Oberlin.
Yes.
Mark Sepidi.
Yes.
Nate Albert.
Yes.
Joe Kubal.
Yes.
Scott Dyke.
Yes.
Motion carries. Thank you.
Okay, we do not have a business promotion this evening. We'll move on to our city attorney, Mike Stiff. Anything?
Good evening, Mayor Council. Nothing.
Any questions of city attorney? Thanks, Mike. Moving on to our management consultant, Steve Golden. Good evening, Steve.
How are you?
Good. How are you?
Good. I have nothing formal under my report. Excuse me. However, I do want to report about Granicus. So we do have some good news. We did finally reach a boss of Granicus. The vice president of implementation contacted me. We have a person flying down from wherever they're coming from to train us. They were very apologetic and want our business, and they're going to get us set up. So we made some headway Friday and today. So I just want to give the board an update on that. So they're actually going to come down, help us set up the portal the way we want it. I also going to have some people from my former place to come here and sit with us during this setup at the same time. Good news.
Thanks, Steve.
Yes.
Okay, any questions of management consultants? All right, thanks, Steve. Moving on, Public Works Department, our Director of Public Works, Mark Seifer. Good evening, Mark.
Good evening, Mayor and Council. I have a few agenda items in front of you this evening. The first, as we discussed at the last work session, is a water main lining contract for Theodore from Clement to Oakland, which will be awarded to Ferpel Infrastructure for not to exceed amount of $169,989.80. Like I said last week, Ferpel is an industry leader in the water main lining sector. I'd be asking for your approval.
So moved.
All right, we have a motion by Alderman Dyke, seconded by Alderman Verche for the approval of water main lining from Theodore from Clement to Oakland to Ferpel Infrastructure for an amount not to exceed $169,989.80. Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Darrell Jefferson.
Yes.
Claudia Gazal.
Yes.
Tina Oberlin.
Yes.
Mark Sepidi.
Yes.
Nate Albert.
Yes.
Joe Kubal.
Yes.
Scott Dyke.
Yes.
John Verche.
Yes.
Motion carries.
The next item on the same memo is a contract for construction engineering with Robinson Engineering for not to exceed amount of $25,000 for the previously mentioned contract. I'd be asking your approval.
So moved.
Second.
We have motion by Alderman Dyke, seconded by Alderman Verche for an approval of construction engineering contract with Robinson Engineering for an amount not to exceed $25,000. Questions or comments? And again, all of these items were discussed last Monday night at our work session. Roll call, please.
Claudia Gazal?
Yes.
Tina Oberlin?
Yes.
Mark Sepidi?
Yes.
Nate Albert?
Yes.
Joe Kubal?
Yes.
Scott Dyke?
Yes.
John Verche?
Yes.
Darrell Jefferson?
Yes.
Motion carries. Thank you.
The next item I had before you is an ordinance to approve the surplus of items for auction from this building with govdeals.com. Included are some desks, filing cabinets, a hydraulic hammer, a 2011 Ford Expedition, and a 2004 Chevy Impala.
So moved, Mayor.
Second.
We have a motion by Alderman Albert, seconded by Alderwoman Gazal for the approval of govdeals.com for surplus equipment. Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Tina Oberlin?
Yes.
Mark Sepidi?
Yes.
Nate Albert?
Yes.
Joe Kubal?
Yes.
Scott Dyke?
Yes.
John Verche?
Yes.
Darrell Jefferson?
Yes.
Claudia Gazal?
Yes.
Motion carries. Ordinance 1876.
The last agenda item I have for you this evening is, as spoke about at the work session last week, every year we are required to speak about our MS4 permit and have a public meeting. As mentioned, in 2003, the Illinois EPA required all municipal separate storm sewer systems to begin complying with statewide general permit conditions. Today, each MS4 community is required to have a fully implemented program addressing each of the six minimum controls as identified by the EPA. The accompanying memo details some of the efforts being made by the City of Crest Hill and Robinson Engineering regarding stormwater pollution prevention. Some of those things include public outreach and education, public involvement and participation, illicit discharge detection and elimination, construction site stormwater runoff control, post-construction stormwater runoff control, and pollution prevention and good housekeeping for municipal operations. With that, I'd be happy to entertain any questions about our MS4 permit or our stormwater discharge.
Any questions from council?
Okay. With that, I just wanted to give council an update. It was posted online earlier. Tomorrow, and for the residents' knowledge, tomorrow we will be cutting the hill on Oakland Avenue. So Oakland Avenue, starting in the morning, we'll have some flaggers out there. So if residents wouldn't mind avoiding that area, if they could. If not, we'll be about a two-hour process to cut the hill on Oakland Avenue, get that taken care of before the winter, and then it'll all be nice and cleaned up for the fall time. With that, I'll entertain any questions.
Any questions of Public Works? Okay, thanks, Mark. Moving on to our city engineer, Ron Wiedemann. Good evening, Ron.
Thank you, Mayor. I just have two items tonight. The first item is to approve the installation of a new crosswalk along with solar-powered pedestrian signs at the Knapp and Will Circle Drive location, and this project will be paid out of MFT funds.
Motion would be
so moved.
Second.
For motion by Alderperson Oberlin, seconded by Alderwoman Gazal for the pedestrian crosswalk at Knapp and Willow Circle Drive. Questions or comments?
I have a comment, Mayor, especially for Ron. You have impressed me over and over and over. I came to you about 3 weeks ago, and here we are. That's how fast you work. I'm so happy that you're part of this city, part of this team, and I think this is going to be a good thing for the residents to, like I said in the work session, to build this bridge between the strip mall and to allow access for the residents that don't have cars to be able to go to breakfast or go for dinner, etc. And also maybe we're hoping it can slow down the traffic a little bit. So good job on that. I really appreciate your hard work.
Okay, roll call, please.
Mark Sepidi?
Yes.
Nate Albert?
Yes.
Joe Kubal?
Yes.
Scott Dyke?
Yes.
John Verche?
Yes.
Darrell Jefferson?
Yes.
Claudia Gazal?
Yes.
Tina Oberlin?
Yes.
Motion carries. Thank you.
The last item I have is to authorize the mayor to execute a professional service agreement with Tescon Associates for the not to exceed amount of $75,855 to update and revise the city's comprehensive plan to include a more detailed sub-area plan for the Crest Hill Business Park as was presented last week.
So moved, Mayor.
Second.
We have a motion by Alderman Albert, seconded by Alderperson Oberlin to authorize an agreement with Tesca Associates for an amount not to exceed $75,855. Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Joe Kubal?
Yes.
Scott Dyke?
Yes.
John Burchett?
Yes.
Darrell Jefferson?
Yes.
Claudia Gazal?
Yes.
Tina Oberlin?
Yes.
Mark Sepidi?
Yes.
Nate Albert?
Yes.
Motion carries. Thank you.
That's all I have, unless anybody has any other questions.
Any questions of our city engineer? All right, thanks, Ron. Community Development Department, no agenda items tonight, and Maura will be here tomorrow. Moving on to our Police Department, our Police Chief Ed Clark. Good evening, Ed.
Evening, Mayor and Council. I have one item on the agenda this evening, and that is for the purchase of high-density shelving for our new evidence area of our new building. The materials are from Bradford Systems. They'll be in two separate rooms in that space. Total purchase is $82,076.79. As we discussed in the last work session, it'll be coming from different sources. Swarm Safety Grant, our Cooperative Police Assistance Team funds, asset forfeiture, and remainder will come out of our operational budget. So this will put us in a great position for the future, and I think it's starting off in the right foot. So
moved as presented.
Second.
We have a motion by Alderperson Oberlin, seconded by Alderman Albert, for the approval of high-density shelving from Bradford Systems for the new police station. Questions or comments?
Yeah, Chief, as you know, I'm big on grants, and I'm always happy to see when we're using not only grants but forfeiture money from what your men are doing, men and women. So thank you.
Thank you. Roll call, please.
Scott Dyke?
Yes.
John Burchett?
Yes.
Darrell Jefferson?
Yes.
Claudia Gazal?
Yes.
Tina Oberlin?
Yes.
Mark Sepidi?
Yes.
Nate Albert?
Yes.
Joe Kubal?
Yes.
Motion carries. Thank you.
Thank you. The only other thing I had was you'll be seeing a lot of the officers are a little more hairy around the face. We're doing the no shave fundraiser again this year. It's been very popular, and it's been one of our larger fundraisers, and one of the main donors that we give to is Special Olympics. So you'll see it. They have to be trimmed. If you see that they're not trimmed, please bring it to my attention. But it's a good event, and we'll be done April 1st.
I think it's your favorite event because you let it grow and grow and
yeah.
Grow.
Yeah, I can't grow up here.
So. Yeah.
That's all I had.
Questions of the police chief? Halloween chief?
Halloween. Thank you, Mayor. Halloween hours are from 3 p.m. to 7 p.m. this year. That's going to be on Sunday. So we will have extra patrol as well, very visible out for all the children. So we'll be out there, and hopefully we'll have a nice, safe Halloween.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
Moving on to Mayor's report, we have before you an approval of a package liquor license for Crest Hill Liquor Incorporated, located at 2400 Caton Farm Road. We had the three gentlemen on the liquor application at our work session last Monday night. They went through all of the requirements to receive a liquor license in the city of Crest Hill. This one is for the property that is currently for CD Liquors Drinny. They are still open. This would be for the approval of a packaged liquor license for the city of Crest Hill. So when all of the requirements are met from the new owner, we will then issue a license for the same property under a new license in the name of Crest Hill Liquors Incorporated. So with that, I would like to invite Kier Taylor to the podium to give council a little information, kind of a follow-up from our work session that we had last Monday night. Taylor?
The city of Crest Hill has required for us the liability insurance that my insurance did send you an email regarding this stuff. And they said we don't need the insurance right now since we're not taking over it, but once the business, everything is okay, then you know, get licensed, everything, we will provide the city of Crest Hill with the insurance from that point of day. So the insurance company said basically you don't need insurance right now. Once you open and establish and everything, then we will get you the insurance right away. And I will submit those papers to city of Crest Hill.
And I did have correspondence with your attorney.
Yeah.
In the past week, and we worked out all those things also.
Perfect. Then the other was a lease agreement, which I have it here. The lease agreement is to July 1st to 2024 to July 30, 2029. So basically, we're just going to sign the same lease and everything, but if City of Crest Hill needs some kind of letter saying that we're going to take over the lease after everything is solved out, I would be happy to tell her and bring you the paper from them.
Yeah, and I think you want to be in as soon as possible.
Exactly. We did call her today, but she was a little busy. We tried to tell her out, but hopefully tomorrow she will get back to us with our email and everything. As soon as I get the agreement signed up and everything, I will drop it to the office.
Okay, any questions of the applicant?
Yeah, is the store going to, the name of the store going to change?
It's going to be same City Liquor.
Okay, so there's not going to be any new signage or anything? It's just a new owner?
Yeah, we just have the corporation as the Crest Hill Liquors, Inc. Okay. So that's about it.
Other than the items, you're waiting to clear up everything else?
Everything basically is cleared up.
Is in place?
Yeah, everything. I do have the incorporate letter here with me, which I'm going to submit it once I have everything. Hopefully, if I get the letter by tomorrow, personally, I will drop it off right away. And then City of Department of for the food and everything, again, they didn't require any type of license or permit or anything, so that's about it.
Okay. Anybody else? I would ask for a motion for an approval.
So moved.
Second.
We have a motion by Alderman Jefferson, seconded by Alderperson Oberlin for the creation of a package liquor license to Crest Hill Liquor Incorporated, which will be located at 2400 Caton Farm Road. Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Nate Albert?
Yes.
Joe Kubal?
Yes.
Scott Dyke?
Yes.
John Verche?
Yes.
Darrell Jefferson?
Yes.
Claudia Gazal?
Yes.
Tina Oberlin?
Yes.
Mark Stapiti?
Yes.
Motion carries. Thank you.
Okay, congratulations. Welcome to the city.
Thank you.
And again, as soon as all of the requirements are met for what we need to have, then I will issue the package liquor license to you. You'll need to display that inside the business near the cash register. And when all the payments are, after all the payments are made, and the other license from the previous owner will be null and void.
Definitely.
Okay? So it's at your speed now, how fast you want to keep this process moving. Okay?
Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Welcome.
One more thing. I know you're doing a charity work. Am I right?
Yes.
From U.S. Tobacco, I will donate about $500 to your charity.
Oh, wow.
Okay, so let me know.
Thank
I can drop off the check or anybody can
good
come.
Good job.
You have my card, correct?
I think so. It's
okay.
Store.
Yeah,
if
just
not,
go ahead.
Then I'll just drop it to the office.
That would be wonderful.
All right.
Thank you.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you. Good luck, you gentlemen. Okay, that's all the agenda items for the mayor. Just one comment. We did have a work crew last Wednesday. We cleaned up the Veterans and Police Memorial Garden. We had about 13 volunteers that helped just to get the garden ready for the winter. We cut down the daylilies, put some things away, and are just waiting to get ready for our move to New City Hall within the next few months. So, but we certainly will maintain this property until it's purchased. And we will maintain this building and the property until the closing of this property happens. So I would personally like to thank all of the volunteers, and they included Alderwoman Claudia Gazal, our city treasurer, Glenn Conklin, Alderman Joe Kubal, Alderman Nate Albert, his son, Trent Albert, Marge Keller, Nick Parks, Dave Seifert, Gary Steig, John Heckman, Rod Berkey, and Vicki Solomon. So thank you. We had a fantastic crew out there. We got everything done in less than 2 hours, and it looks very nice for the winter season. So again, my heartfelt gratitude to everyone that came out and helped. With that, that's all the items I have. I would be certainly try to answer any questions that anybody may have. Hearing none, we will move on to our city clerk's report. Our city clerk, Christine Verche-Hall. Good evening, Chris.
Good evening. The only thing I have to report is the Crest Hill City Clerk's Office will be collecting Christmas cards along with snack-sized candy bars to donate to Operation Care Package. City staff will be delivering the cards and candy to their drop-off site in Manhattan on Veterans Day. If you would like to sign the cards, please feel free to, but we ask you to please do not seal them. And if you should have any questions, please contact the clerk's office at 815-741-5100. And that's all I have to report.
Any questions of city clerk? All right, thanks, Chris. City treasurer's report, our treasurer, Glenn Conklin. Good evening, Glenn.
Good evening, Mayor and Council. I'd like to report regular and overtime payroll from September 27th, 2021 through October 10th of 2021 in the amount of $228,719.50. I look for your approval on a list of bills. Same time period totaled $777,670.82.
So moved as presented.
Second.
We have motion by Alderperson Oberlin, seconded by Alderman Jefferson for the approval of the list of bills. Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Claudia Gazal?
Yes.
Dean Oberlin?
Yes.
Mark Sapiti?
Yes.
Nate Albert?
Yes.
Joe Kubal?
Yes.
Scott Dyke?
Yes.
John Verche?
Yes.
Darrell Jefferson?
Yes.
Motion carries. Thank you.
Thank you all. I'll take any questions if you have them.
Questions of city treasurer? All right. Thanks, Glenn.
Thank you.
Unfinished business, we have nothing on the agenda. Anyone? New business, we have nothing. Anyone? Committee liaison reports. Anybody?
Yes. We also had a cleanup in conjunction with the John Pritisil and the Czech people up there in his neighborhood. So I just want to thank John and his neighbor Jerry, Vicki Hackney, myself, and I really want to thank one of the Newmark employees, one of my tellers, Martha Rico. She came out. She doesn't even live in the city of Crest Hill, but she thought it was such a wonderful thing that she spent 3 hours of her day out there with us, and we really got a lot accomplished for the small crew we had. So I want to thank all of them for doing that. You know, there's only two of us that actually live in Crest Hill, but it's nice to see people get involved, so I want to thank all of them.
Okay, anybody else on committee liaison reports? City Council comments, positive City Council comments. Anything you'd like to share with your constituents? We'll begin with Ward 3 this evening, Alderperson Oberlin.
Well, I want to wish everyone a happy Halloween. I know it's coming faster than we can imagine, but please, all the kids that'll be out there, it's on a Sunday, so we've had extended hours. Put the lights on and be careful when they're out there, you know, with the kids. They're probably going to be very excited if we have good weather this year. It's been so bad. And watch out for them, and happy Halloween to everybody.
Alderman Sapiti?
Yes, I would like to announce and let the residents know that on Tuesday, October 26th, there will be a fundraising event at the Chipotle restaurant at 2848 Plainfield Road in Joliet, over by the mall. This is a fundraiser for the Courtyard Committee of Richland School. The hours are from 4 to 8. Again, it's Tuesday, October 26th, and 33% of all sales will go are donated to the Richland School from Chipotle. Thank you.
Ward 4, Alderman Albert.
Yeah, Mayor, just to announce to go along with the Halloween, the Crest Hill Lions Club is bringing back their Halloweeny roast. It'll run the same hours as Halloween at the three locations like usual. I got the Richland Center at Sweetbriar and Linwood, at Cheney School, and also at the park at Boreo and Tahoe. With the extended hours, I'd recommend getting there a little bit early because there is a limited number of hot dogs available that day. So, but it will start at 3 o'clock. Of course, subject to change if there's any restrictions put in place. Thank you.
Alderman Kubal?
Nothing else to add there, Mayor.
Ward 1, Alderman Dyke?
Nothing to add. It's already been said, Mayor. Thank you.
Alderman Verche?
Nothing.
Ward 2, Alderman Jefferson?
Nothing at this time.
And Alderwoman Gazal?
I just want to take a moment and talk about our second pop-up food pantry. I don't want to get emotional. You know, I put my heart and soul in this. My pastor like saw the vision that I had, and my favorite part it was when over 25 volunteers, we all hold a circle and we started praying, and it just shows you like the power of people when they get together. I do want to thank Calvary Church of Naperville, especially Pastor Kyle, for continuing his hard work and dedication to spread so much love throughout Illinois, not just here in Crest Hill, throughout Illinois. And I also want to thank Becky with Aurora Food Pantry. She has dedicated her soul to this for many years. And Crest Hill Library for allowing us to use the parking lot. Also, we just put Crest Hill on the map, if you guys don't realize that. We are in a newspaper in Aurora. We are in a newspaper in Calvary. We are a newspaper in Naperville. And it's good to see that we are in a newspaper for something positive. So, and I also want to thank all the volunteers. Mrs. Solomon, she was working really hard. Our treasurer for bringing coffee to all the volunteers because it was kind of windy and cold. And to the resident that they came and helped me move food for the people that don't have any cars. So this is something that's going to continue with the upcoming years, and I'm hoping it will get bigger and bigger. We fed 189 kids, so I'm very, very blessed to be able to do this too for my town. Thank you, Mayor.
Public comment. Anyone would like to address council, please step to the podium, state your name for the record. Your address is optional. Let the record show that no one has approached the podium. To our management consultant, Steve, is there a need for an executive session?
Yes, Mayor and Council, we have two items before you tonight in executive session. One is regarding pending and threatening litigation, and second is personnel. I would ask that we go to executive session.
Okay, motion would be in
so
order.
So moved.
Second.
We have motion by Alderperson Overland, seconded by Alderman Cipitti for executive session. Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Nate Albert.
Yes.
Joe Kubal.
Yes.
Scott Dyke.
Yes.
John Verche.
Yes.
Darrell Jefferson.
Yes.
Claudia Gazal.
Yes.
Tina Overland.
Yes.
Mark Cipitti.
Yes.
Motion carries. Thank you.
Okay, we'll be going into executive session at 7:28 p.m.